Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to a special edition of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. This is the Volunteer Slam Preview, the road to Knoxville. Hello, everybody. I'm Phil Rainey. We're standing outside the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, and joining me is manager Jim Cornette. Jim, this coming Friday night, one of the biggest wrestling events ever to come to Knoxville, will crown the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Champion. This is going to be a big night for wrestling fans in this area.
That's right, Phil Rainey. It's going to be a historic night because returning to the scene of some of the greatest matches in the history of professional wrestling, the Knoxville Civic Coliseum this Friday night is going to be the Volunteer Slam. And today on the program, we're not only going to examine the participants, examine the first round pairings for the heavyweight title tournament, but we're also going to see all of those guys in action. We're going to hear their thoughts on exactly how they expect to win the tournament this Friday night. And also, as you see on the screen right now, the first round pairings, the winners of these matches will return in semifinal matches, and the two remaining men will meet in the main event to determine the first Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion, with Commissioner Bob Armstrong presenting the belt to the winner. And brother, let me tell you something, Bullet Bob has won quite a few championships here in this building himself, so it should be quite a night.
So wrestling fans, don't go away. The action returns in just a moment. Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team. Fans, we're inside the Knoxville Coliseum. We're ready to take a look at some of the eight competitors involved in Friday night's Volunteer Slam Heavyweight Championship Tournament.
And I'll tell you something, Phil Rainey, doesn't it send chills and shivers down your spine to be here in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, the site of so many great matches all the great wrestlers have been through here? From Ron Wright and Whitey Caldwell on to Ron and Robert Fuller, Bob Armstrong, the Briscoes, the Funks, the Mongolian Stomper, Ronnie Garvin. It's a historic building. And the guy who wins that tournament Friday night is going to have some mighty big shoes to fill, because he's going to step up there with the great ones. And this is the prize right here. The Smoky Mountain Wrestling Heavyweight Championship belt, signifying the best wrestler in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Whoever gets this is going to have to do a whole lot of fighting, a whole lot of scratching, and a whole lot of deep down searching his guts to find out just exactly how tough he really is. This is the prize Friday night. It's going to have to be a bad son of a gun that goes and gets it. I'll tell you that right now.
Now let's meet two wrestlers involved in Friday night's Volunteer Slam Heavyweight Tournament, Dixie Dynamite and the Dirty White Boy, managed by Ron Wright. We'll see the action that brought these two into the tournament, and then we'll hear from them.
Time with this goofball, this man. Call him that. Now, I'm trying to throw a real good punch.
I don't know why you're so touchy about wearing the heck he's been for the last 3 weeks.
See, I told him that. I said, if he throws a drop kick, hang on to the closest thing. I don't care if it's an old woman in the front row. Hang on to her and make him miss it. Yes, sir.
Are you going to ignore me about that?
Why? Why? Why?
As I say, I still don't know why you're upset about where he's been for the last...
He was probably drunk. I don't know. He suffers from delusions.
All right, Styles now with Dixie Dynamite.
See, I called him that. See that backbreaker? I called him that. Look at that.
He's got some big hooks, but he can't hold him on the count of one.
Yeah, but he got him down. Boy, my boy's doing real good. He's an idiot, but he's doing real good right now. Now, if he follows what I told him to do, he'll win.
There comes Dixie Dynamite off the road.
Oh!
What happened? He's holding right on that chin.
He's a moron. He's a moron. Look at him.
And what Dixie Dynamite on the offense right now.
He's a moron. Oh.
Boy, he is taking the fight to Carl Stiles.
Oh. Man.
Stiles draped in the corner. I think the ropes are the only thing holding him up.
Wait a minute. Now he's taking advantage of him.
He's got him in the corner.
I'm going down there. I've got to tell him something.
And Dutch Mantel is leaving us to go down to ringside. And here's Styles into the corner, just being pounded at and
come
pounded
on,
away
on.
Under the top come of the on. Head by the Dixie Dynamite. Reversal now by Styles. Good power slam, and he had the shoulder in it. Dutch now calls Styles over to say something to him into the corner.
Come on, what are you doing?
There's that kick. Dixie Dynamite, when Styles turned around, he got him with a kick, covered him for the 1-2-3.
The winner of the match, Dixie Dynamite.
What happened?
This coming Friday night. Knoxville Coliseum this Friday we're talking about. Double D coming to you all the way live in the first round of the Volunteer Slam Tournament. And who do I have? None other than the DWB Dirty White Boy with Rotten Ron Wright. I'll be coming to you, boys, and I'll tell you what. If all my little firecrackers are behind me that evening, then I'll tell you Double D's going to come out on top and the South will rise again.
Good, Mr. Wright. Mr. Wright's my hero. I've been a fan of Mr. Wright for a long time.
That doesn't surprise me for some reason, Dutch. I thought that from behind. Oh, my heavens.
That's a signature.
Where's sportsmanship? From behind he got him, blindsided him.
Well, he hit him from behind because Mag's trying to run away.
Neckbreaker. Oh, man, did he put the power behind that one. That brought a smile to the face of Mr. Ron Wright as well as the Dirty White Boy, but Mag's got his shoulder up at the count of two.
Well,
almost had him for three.
I think what White Boy's doing right now, he's just punishing Joey Maggs.
That
he's punishing him for having the audacity to step in the same ring with him.
Well, he brought him out of that corner with that snapmare. Look how... Oh, he missed that. He was going to splatter him with that splash.
Well, Maggs had the presence of mind to move. But let's see who's damaged most here, Maggs or White Boy.
And there's Maggs, who got to his feet in time to land that right hand right to the jaw and another one. That sends the White Boy reeling back into the ropes. The Irish whip across the ring, high into the air with that back toss.
Well, he's got a little offense going. Can he keep it up?
Good block. He's got him covered with a press. Oh, only two. He didn't have a leg hook. Couldn't hold him there.
The Dirty White Boy is a tough guy to beat. Now, see, these things have a marginal effect on White Boy.
Oh, that was another mistake on the part of Maggs. He showed you a good move earlier, and then that time, the White Boy caught him looking.
Side suplex.
And he won't get up from that one.
He took him right down.
The winner, the Dirty White Boy.
Whoa, Daddy, this Friday night, I can't wait. It's the 22nd. It's coming down in K-Town. One of the biggest things that's ever happened in a long time, and I'm talking about the Volunteer Slam. Now, you people are probably wondering, where's my sweet manager, Ron Wright? Well, he checked himself in to a home because he wants to get plenty of rest for this Friday night. And it, you know, I'm just getting so excited. I don't know what to do with myself because, Dixie Dynamite, you made the misfortune of getting me the first round. Now, you got a real fancy karate kick. Well, brother, I've been hit in the face with chains, brass knuckles, chairs, and I'm still standing. And it don't matter if it's Tim Horner or that big mule head primetime Brian Lee. It don't matter who it is, boys, because when you walk that aisle and the final bell rings, you're going to look at the man that you're going to call the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Champion. And there's nothing you can do about it.
There'll be sparks flying on Friday night when Dixie Dynamite goes against the Dirty White Boy managed by Ron Wright. We'll be right back with more action and more first-round competitors after this.
You'd love to have something like this, wouldn't you, Phil?
I'd love to have that, yes.
Fans, back to Smoky Mountain Wrestling in the heart of West Virginia in just a moment. First, these reminders. Wrestling will be in Beckley on Sunday afternoon, May 17th at 2 p.m. It's WOAY TV Channel 4 Day. All kids 12 and under, only 4 cents with a paid adult. That's at the Raleigh County Armory. Now, you'll see such stars as this. Dixie Dynamite will take on Dutch Mantell. Tim Horner will wrestle Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Robert Gibson against Jimmy Golden. Brian Lee will take on the Dirty White Boy, who will have in his corner Mr. Ron Wright. A special referee for that match is Bob Armstrong. Six big matches in all, fans, on that card. Right now, let's bring in primetime Brian Lee and Bob Armstrong, the special referee for this match.
First of all, Bob, I want to thank Mr. Armstrong for agreeing to do this match with me. You know, Dirty White Boy, you're great at running up beside somebody and hitting them in the back with a chair, and your Ron Wright, so-called manager, is always handing something in there. So I went out to get a man to call it right down the middle, and he'll tell you about it.
You know, Bob, one thing about it, as commissioner, I have to call it right down the middle. I intend to do that. Now, I didn't go for Dirty White Boy running out and hitting this big man in the back with a 2x4 or whatever it was, but it didn't take the big man down. But then you've got to worry about Mr. Ron Wright, who's always sliding him this and handing him this, yeah, and an outside interference. So one thing about it, when I get to Beckley, West Virginia, I'm going to call this right down the middle. And, Brian, If you can beat the Dirty White Boy, more power to you. But if he beats you, I've got to count your shoulders out, too. I want you to understand that. I'm a fair referee. I've got the contract in my hand. I intend to sign it right now. I'll be there in Beckley. That's Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock. Hope everybody comes out. A lot of matches there. The last time I was there, Bob, I was a wrestler. This time, I'm a professional referee. And as commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, I'm proud to be there to represent him. I'm going to call it right down the middle. Dirty White Boy, Mr. Wright, be on your best. Be on your toes, brother. And the same goes for you, Brian.
And you can bet I will.
Bob. All right, fans, that's going to be a great one. It's going to be in Beckley. That's Sunday the 17th, 2 p.m. Don't you miss it. We'll see you right there.
Now, fans, let's continue with a preview of the action you'll see this Friday night in the Volunteer Slam Tournament. A man who's no stranger to Knoxville, Tennessee, is Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Let's see Buddy in action, and then we'll hear his comments.
I like Buddy.
And it's very obvious to me that with Brian Lee's comments that we heard just a few moments ago, Dutch, that he's going to be coming at Buddy Landell full bore at the Volunteer Slam.
Oh, big deal. So Brian Lee, he's like a lot of other wrestlers. They talk a tough game, but when it comes time to really produce, they don't really know what they want to do. They can get out here and say, oh, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. But when push comes to shove, they might not do anything. I think Buddy Landell, May 22nd, Volunteer Slam, Knoxville, Tennessee, at the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, just in case there's any doubt in anybody's mind, the date and the time and the place of Volunteer Slam, I think he's going to take Brian Lee and he's going to whoop him like he licked the gold cookie.
Well, right now, Nitro Danny Davis really hurt. He caught a couple of big hard right hands right to the side of the head. There's a thumb to the eye. Landell, each time that Davis comes back, he counters with a good move on his part. There was a good reversal by Nitro Danny Davis. He's been very impressive in the tag team tournament. He and Joey Maggs got a great win over the Koloffs. You mentioned that earlier before being stopped by the Heavenly Bodies, and that was in the second round of that tournament.
Oh, that is right. He has stepped in the ring with the Heavenly Bodies. And yes, he has. I remember now.
In a tag team match.
Yes, I remember. And he got the suit beat out of him. I remember somebody telling me that Danny Davis was actually in the dressing room crying in a towel that he lost.
Landell back crawling back toward the corner and right on top of him.
Now, nobody,
is Davis.
Nobody likes to see a man cry, Bob. Not even their ex-wives.
Right.
No, they don't.
Davis now again with that foot right into that muscle. Goes right back to that leg, working on that left leg of Buddy Landell. You get them wheels and hurt, get him off of them wheels.
Well,
if he's on one wheel, he's in trouble.
When those wheels go out, you have a lot of difficulty moving around that ring. When your wheels go, you might as well throw in the towel.
Well, and Davis is right on top of it. Danny Davis has got to use his quickness right here on Nature Boy Buddy Landell. But it's hard to do when a guy will come with a move like that. Again, the finger right to the eye. Buddy Landell is the epitome of a wrestler in the ring that'll do anything to win the match.
Well, that's what it takes to win. See, we're in Smoky Mountain Wrestling now. This is where the tough guys hang out. It's not like a lot of other federations where, you know, the guys paint their faces and do things like this. These are wrestlers here. We're not promoting bruise cruises, and we're not promoting, you know, dolls. We're talking about the emphasis is put on wrestling. And this is where the tough guys hang out. If you're tough enough, you can hang with the big boys. If you can't hang with the big boys, if you can't run with the big dogs, then stay on the porch.
Hey, Dutch, we understand now from the director that Commissioner Bob Armstrong and Bobby Fullen will have some comments about Jackie's injury before we go off of the air.
Wait a minute.
It stands right now. The Heavenly Bodies are the new Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. You saw that win right there by the Nature Boy.
Okay, Buddy Landell going into the tournament on a winning note. I need to...
You know it must be a crying shame Brian Lee grows up a loser, hangs out with Sawyer Brown, a bunch of other kind of losers. Brian, let me explain something to you, pal. This is Smoky Mountain Wrestling. This ain't like those other organizations you've wrestled for where you go around going, oh, you can't hit me that hard. Daddy said sell. Or you walk around with extra thick knee pads on like this. You got to fight your way to the top here. See what I'm talking about? So this Friday night, pal, the Volunteer Jam, Knoxville, Tennessee, the Nature Boy's going to pull your eyes out and whistle through your skull. Let me explain something to you. They got some couple of chairs hanging out for you and Sawyer Brown with your names on them called Lazy Boy. You walk into your house and you say, well, I should have, I could have, I would have, but the bottom line is you didn't, and they never did. And then you're sitting there in that Lazy Boy, and then you stick it on down into Loser, and that's where you're going to be for the rest of your life. This is the Nature Boy Buddy Landell talking to you, son. Smoky Mountain Wrestling, where the tough guys get the breaks.
Knoxville, Tennessee's own Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
Hey, let me tell you something. Nature Boy Buddy Landell's one of my favorites, and he's disowned Knoxville. He's moved to Jacksonville, Florida now. But I tell you something, the guy he's going up against in the tournament is supposedly everybody's fair-haired boy, everybody's hero, everybody's idol, Primetime Brian Lee.
Now let's take a look at Primetime Brian Lee in this special video spotlight, and then we'll hear from the most popular wrestler in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Brian Lee.
May 22nd, Volunteer Slam. Buddy Landell, you can count on one thing. Primetime Brian Lee will be ready, and I will be there. 6'8", 280 pounds in your face all night. Now, I'm going to take a second to give credit where credit's due. You do come out here and run your chops real good, but let's see how good you wrestle in Knoxville. Volunteer Slam, Primetime, I'm coming.
Primetime Brian Lee has to be a favorite, but there's more heavy hitters to come. We'll be right back after these messages.
Brian Lee ain't got a chance.
Fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling debuts in Beckley at the Raleigh County Armory on Sunday afternoon, May 17th at 2 p.m. It's Channel 4 Day. All children under 12 admitted for only 4 cents with paid adult. The main event, Smoky Mountain's tag team title, Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies versus Oak Hill's Bart and Brad Batten. The Dirty White Boy takes on Primetime Brian Lee with Bob Armstrong, the special referee. White Lightning Tim Horner meets Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Three other matches, and remember, all kids under 12, only 4 cents with a paid adult. Don't miss it. Wrestling fans, we're here at the ticket window of the Knoxville Civic Coliseum for this Friday night's matches. Before we get back to more action, let's hear the special statement from the executive director of the Coliseum, Paul Sherbakoff.
It's a real pleasure for me to be able to visit with you today about Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I've witnessed their growth here in the Knoxville market, and it's been real exciting. And we're indeed honored to have been selected to host the May 22nd Volunteer Slam, and I think that's indicative of the way the Knoxville market has taken to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and I personally am looking forward to seeing most of you here on May 22nd.
What do you mean all the front row ringside seats are sold out for Friday night? My mother's coming to the matches.
Front row seats are sold.
Well, wrestling fans, in addition to the heavyweight championship match of the Volunteer Slam, and by the way, we'll see more of those competitors in just a moment, it'll be the first defense ever of the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Championship. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies will take on the Party Patrol, Johnny and Davey Rich.
Yeah, you know, that brings a smile to my face. And you know, for maybe all you people who've been living in a cave or living under a rock don't know exactly what happened to the Fantastics, what kind of accident befell poor Jackie Fulton. Let's go back to the videotape of last week and take a look at poor little Jackie's injury.
All right, fans, back to the action in the ring. Pritchard now with Bobby Fulton held high into the air. Kept him right there until he got it just at the right moment with that suplex, and he had a full power behind that one. That was a tremendous suplex right there, Dutch.
Well, fans, while you were away, nothing changed. The Heavenly Bodies are aggressive. They're pressing the attack on the Fantastics. And I think they're showing these young men from either the City of Angels or Chillicothe, Ohio, what it's like to really be in a championship wrestling match right now. The people are standing here in the arena. It's been a hard-fought match. The Fantastics, they need to get some kind of offense going, and they need to get it going real quick.
Fulton right there with a good move as he bridged right up and then caught Pritchard with that head right into the eye.
Yeah, but the mark of a good team, he reached right back and he made the tag. He got a fresh man back in the ring.
All right, Stan Lane now, still Fulton in the ring. Bobby Fulton. Fulton comes off the rope, gets a foot right into the face of Lane. Lane again made a tag. Well, as you said, Cornette's got him prepared. He always does. They tag and they tag often, and they try to keep a fresh man in the ring, and they know where they are in the ring at all times, Dutch. They know how far they are away from their corner, whether or not they can make the tag. The clothesline from Pritchard. Fulton down again. Bobby Fulton. He needs to make a tag.
Well, fans, right now, just a few minutes or maybe in the next couple of seconds, we could be seeing the first Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, either the Heavenly Bodies or the Fantastics. My personal bet, my personal odds go with the Heavenly Bodies. They even go more strongly now, but even before the match started, I'd have to lay money on the Heavenly Bodies just because of Jim Cornette in the corner and the way he has his team prepared.
Well, Pritchard made the tag, and here's Lane right back in. Fulton's Bobby still in the ring. You know, the rivalry between these men goes back a long, long way.
They made the tag.
Here comes Jackie Fulton in. He's fresh. He's ready to go. Down goes both of the Heavenly Bodies. When they get up, they go right back down. Power slam. He's going to slam Pritchard also. Standing drop kick. And another one. Down goes Pritchard. First the slams, then the drop kick.
Well, let's see if they can finish him off now. They got the momentum in their corner.
And together they come. Boy, Jackie Fulton is like a wild man in the ring. The elbow on Lane as he comes off of the ropes. One, two. I started to say, Dutch, that this rivalry goes back a long way. Jim Cornette's team of the Midnight Express were close to Bobby Fulton. See that? Tommy Rogers in 1985. Nothing has really changed. Nothing has been settled in that long-running feud.
Well, the luck seems to be... The luck seems to be going with the Fantastics right now. Tom Pritchard back up. Bobby Fulton back up.
Well, you saw Jackie come way off of that top rope. He ducked right under that big right hand. He's got the sleeper now on Stan Lane. And the referee from behind. There's Jim Cornette. Cornette with a tennis racket.
Let's see if they can get him.
He's going to be pinned.
New champions.
And the winners of the match and the new Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, the Heavenly Bodies, and they're managed by Jim Cornette.
Well, what a way for the championship and the belts to change hands.
Wait a minute.
Jim Cornette with the tennis ball. There's Bobby Fulton. What a big right hand right on the jaw, Jim Cornette.
See there, sore loser.
Head goes down.
Yeah, okay.
There's Stan Lane with a belt to the back of Bobby Fulton. Well, and Pritchard now going after Jackie Fulton. Here's Cornette back. Both of them now.
See, they're sore losers. They can't accept defeat. But they're going to have to face it. It's right in their face right now. They have been defeated by the best wrestling team in the profession today, the Heavenly Bodies, managed by Jim Cornette.
Well, there
wait a minute,
Lane.
What's the stand?
He's going to get him in the figure four, looks like.
He's got him in the figure four.
And he could really hurt him with that, Dutch.
Now, what they've done, they've neutralized
him. Look at this. There comes Pritchard right down on that leg while Stan had him in the figure four.
A lot of pressure in that figure four anyway.
And he goes back with that knee. He's trying to injure the guy. There's no doubt in my mind that they're trying to injure Jackie Fulton. Here comes Robert Gibson, Dixie Dynamite.
Yeah, and Brian, we got to restore order, fans. All right, and fans, with me right now, Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Commissioner?
Well, I just want to say that I don't know exactly how bad Jackie Fulton is hurt, but the swelling tells me that he's going to be out of wrestling for quite a few weeks. Now, I've offered Bobby Fulton more partners, but he doesn't want any partner but his brother, and I can certainly understand that. Since all four of those men volunteered to go in a non-sanctioned match, I have to declare here and now that the Heavenly Bodies are the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions.
Okay, there. And here is Bobby Fulton. Bobby?
I want to tell you something right now. Listen, I'm getting ready to take my brother to the hospital, brother, but you can count us down right now, but not out. I've got one thing to say right now. We're coming back after Coronet's Heavenly Bodies, and when we get back, I guarantee one thing right now for certain. You know, Bob, you said Tim Horner's wanted to be my partner. Robert Gibson's wanted to be my partner. But hey, they're not my brother. They're not my partner. I'm going to stand out and wait. But Coronet and Heavenly Bodies, when we get back, you can be rest assured one thing. You're going to see one hell of a fight.
All right, and Commissioner, a lot of this is going on, and a lot of guys are being hurt.
Well, a lot of tension, a lot of unnecessary injuries, but like I say, I'm doing the best job I can.
Yes,
you
sir,
can see the egos
job
I've got to deal with. So all I can say is the pile driver is illegal. It will be illegal no matter what Mr. Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful says, and Hector Guerrero will get his shot. As far as Jackie Fulton, we'll have to wait and see. The leg looks pretty bad. They're icing it down, about to take him to the hospital.
Well, wrestling fans, you heard Jackie Fulton's knee is damaged, cartilage damage, ligament tear. He's going to be out for about 4 to 5, maybe possibly 6 weeks. And you heard Bobby Fulton say that he's not going to return until Jackie is well enough to get in the ring.
Well, that just breaks my heart not to get to see Bobby Fulton around here. You know, let me just correct you about one thing. It's not a ligament tear. It's a partial ligament tear. A full ligament tear would have been a whole lot worse. Better to break your leg than have a full anterior cruciate ligament tear. That's what we were going for. Unfortunately, we didn't quite succeed. But Fantastics, I promise you this, if you have the guts, which I doubt, to come back in the ring in Smoky Mountain Wrestling and face the Heavenly Bodies, the Gangster of Love and the Doctor of Desire, Stan Lane and Tom Pritchard, then you're going to get worse the next time. Now, as for Friday night, the Party Patrol, Johnny and Davey Rich, they're the first ones to get in line, challenge the new tag team champions. Well, I got news for you, Johnny and Davey Rich. After this match, they're not going to call you the Party Patrol. They're going to be calling the Highway Patrol because it's going to look like a wreck on Interstate 75 when we get finished with you. You don't seem to understand. Stan Lane, Tom Pritchard, and Jim Cornette don't play games. The Fantastic have had that point driven home, and driven home very successfully, I might add. And now Johnny and Davey Rich, all the people in East Tennessee think you're hot, and all these corn-fed farm women, they think you're great. The Party Patrol, I guess everybody wants to play Hank Williams Jr. and dance and drink some beer for about $1.95 a six-pack and make a big deal. Well, let me tell you something. We party just a little bit differently. We party by taking rednecks and slapping them around and putting them in their place, and we party by taking those corn-fed women that you got running around with you. We take them and we turn them out in the street where they belong because they are not going to touch the Heavenly Bodies. Friday night at the Volunteer Slam, brother, we're going to be stronger. Just a little longer.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team. Wrestling fans, let's get back to the heavyweight championship for just a moment. We'll take a look at some of those contestants who will be appearing in the first round. Now, a couple of the contestants you'll see brings a heated argument to a head. And you'll see Jimmy Golden and also rock and roll Robert Gibson. Let's take a look at these contestants.
The takedown right there by Gibson now. You know, he's been wanting a shot, too, at Jimmy Golden since their match here a few weeks ago. And that ended with Akolov's getting all involved in it. And he really, I think, deserves that match with Golden, too, Dutch.
Well, whether he deserves it or not, it's another story of whether he'll get it or not. I don't think he wants it as much as he says he does. You know, these guys really talk a tough game, say, I want this guy, I want that guy. But when push comes to shove, you know, he may be just saying that for political reasons, his own little motives, you know. And sometimes, say if Jimmy Golden took him up on it, he may have an illness, an injury, or anything. And also talking about that, I think the Fantastics, I think they will come up with some lame excuse today why they're not going to be here.
Oh, no, I'm sure they're going to be here. There you see some of the fans. that are enjoying the action here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling is Kazana now, putting Gibson out toward the center of the ring at Snapmare. And with that chin lock now from behind.
Now, Kazanas is a very good wrestler. A very good. All he needs, I think he might need to take a few tips from me. I'll just throw it out. I am the master of strategy. Take a few tips from me, and I believe I could tell him how to beat Robert Gibson in under 10 minutes.
Gibson, I think, is the type of guy that's got it all, Dutch. He's got good size. He's big enough to have a lot of power. Yet he's also got the speed and the stamina that you need to get in there and really mix it up over a long period of time.
One thing he is lacking is the killer instinct. When he has an opponent hurt, he really doesn't know really how to apply that pressure. And that's what you have to have to be successful in professional wrestling. You have to have that killer instinct.
Oh, boy. Kazana was going to give him the back toss high to the air coming off of the ropes. Gibson saw that one, hold him up in that small package, but it could only hold him for the count of two.
Kazana's telegraphed that move right there.
Oh, look at his scoop slam. He just scoops him right up, slams him now hard to the mat.
Joe Kazana's going on the top rope right now. Either an elbow drop or a knee drop.
A dangerous high impact move too when he got so high into the air and he missed that one.
Well, he took a chance with it.
Hard.
He took a chance and he missed it.
Back toss, and it's Kazana who goes high to the air.
Now the offense is in Robert Gibson's court. Now let's see if he can capitalize on this.
Well, Kazana came charging into the corner. I tell you, I was a little bit headlong on that as he runs right into that elbow, the whip across the ring. Look at that knee lift.
Well, that was a good knee lift. I'll give him credit for that. A good knee lift. And works on some people.
Dutch, you know, a little later on, and I can hardly wait.
One,
hear
two,
from eight. Bob Armstrong. And I'll tell you fans about that later.
Your winner, Rock and Roll Robert Gibson.
You know, Jimmy Gold, my wish came true because right here on Friday night, this Friday night at Volunteer Slam, it's going to be me and you, Sonny Boy. I told the whole world that I'm going to beat you. And Jimmy Gold, right there in Volunteer Slam, I'm going to beat you because you run a tough shot around everybody else, but not on me, boy. I'm undefeated here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Let me tell you something, boy, rock and roll is going to keep going.
Tommy Angel better enjoy his little bit of glory in the sun, so to speak, because when Jimmy Golden regroups outside the ring, he's going to come back and he's going to take care of Mr. Angel. I've known Jimmy Golden for several years, and I've never known him to back away from anyone. He's just like Ivan Koloff and his nephew. They don't back away from any fight and win most of them.
Golden is awfully slow to get up outside of the ring, and fans, you see, as he really was favoring that back, slowly now walking around the ring.
And you didn't see Bob Armstrong when he left a while ago. He looked at me funny. He gave me a funny look as he walked away.
What do you mean
too.
A funny look?
Funny, just looked at me funny. You can tell when somebody looks at you funny. He just looked at me like, you know, I don't know. He just looked at me funny. He doesn't like me anyway. That's because I used to beat the fool out of him and his snot-nosed brats. They said one time Bob Armstrong was a great father because he used to walk his son to school every day. Well, that was fine. Real convenient for Bob, seeing as how they're both in the same grade anyway.
Angel goes sailing high in the air, coming off of the ropes with that big back toss. Golden, as we say, is a tall one, about 6'6", 6'7". He gets you high in the air. Has he got him pinned, Dutch? Only a count of two.
No, he does not. I could have told you that 10 minutes ago.
Here's Angel now with some good hard right hands. Going to whip him out across the ring. Good hard right hand when he came off. He's got the leg hook, but again, he can't hold him. Boy, Angel showing his power, too, as he just picks up Golden. Lifts him high in the air, slams him hard to the mat. Goes for the pin again, and Dutch, I tell you, Golden still has just got too much steam. He can't pin him. He can't hold him down.
Well, he's got too much ring sand.
What a drop.
Look at that. That's one of the best drop kicks in wrestling today.
He's going to pin him out of it. Big, tall. Jimmy Golden with a drop kick.
Jimmy Golden with a great win. Well, he's just going to keep on this
Angel. He's not satisfied, is he?
Well, I think he may embarrass Jimmy just a little bit.
What the heck?
Now, Jimmy, he's just going to make
sure. The guy just kicking and stomping away at him. Angel.
Well,
he's defenseless in the ring right now. He's got him on the apron. Look at, hey, wait a minute. Here comes Robert Gibson.
Now, what's he going in the ring for? What did Robert Gibson go in the ring? There's no need for that. Come on, boy.
Robert Gibson, you know I've got myself a real big reputation of beating up your family, including you. Everybody here in East Tennessee knows that I can do it too, brother. I have beat you before. I beat your brother. You just ask him. I slapped his face real good before. Your mama, your daddy, the whole family. and I'm going to take care of you Friday night in Knoxville, brother, at that Coliseum at the Volunteer Slam, and I'm going to be going right on up to the main event.
Friday night here in Knoxville, Tennessee, Gibson and Golden, regardless of who wins this match, it's going to be a tremendous battle. When we return, we'll take a look at another match. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and the man who stands in his way for the title, White Lightning Tim Horner. That'll be after this. Fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling debuts in Beckley at the Raleigh County Armory on Sunday afternoon, May 17th at 2 p.m. It's Channel 4 Day. All children under 12 admitted for only 4 cents with paid adult. The main event, Smoky Mountain's tag team title, Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies versus Oak Hill's Bart and Brad Batten. The Dirty White Boy takes on primetime Brian Lee with Bob Armstrong, the special referee. White Lightning Tim Horner meets Nature Boy Buddy Landell. 3 other matches, and remember, all kids under 12, only 4 cents with a paid adult. Don't miss it.
You don't have any front row. You're supposed to be Ticketmaster. It's for my mother. She can what?
Well, wrestling fans, before we take a look at the final first round matchup in our Volunteer Slam, we'd like to let you know about a very special event coming to TV next week. It's Mountain Mayhem.
Well, I'll tell you something. That's going to be quite an event for television. A Mountain Mayhem Battle Royal. 18 men. And it's not a normal Battle Royal. You see, back in the dressing room before the match, all the names are put in a hat and then drawn out one by one. That determines the order of the participants. The first two guys drawn enter the ring and wrestle for 2 minutes. Then the third man whose name was drawn enters the ring and he joins it for 2 minutes. Every 2 minutes after that, another man enters the ring. The only way you can be eliminated is by being thrown over the top rope. There's no disqualification, and $5,000 goes to the winner of Mountain Mayhem, so it's going to be one heck of a confrontation. I know what these guys will do for $5,000, brother, next week.
Now, wrestling fans, let's meet a man who is no stranger to championships, a man whose attitude has changed drastically over the past several weeks, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
My man.
Now, Paul was entered in this tournament as a wild card.
Well, I tell you what, he was a wild card entrant, but he soon proved that he was more than capable of going straight to the top in the tournament. Let's take a look at exactly what his reaction was to being a wild card entrant in the tournament.
It's going to be a great tournament, and our other wild card entrant right here, Mr. Wonderful himself, Paul Orndorff. Paul?
You know, all this gaga and this goo-goo, how glad you are to be here. Well, as far as I'm concerned, it's an insult to me. Mr. Wonderful, hey, that's Paul, not Paul Orndorff, it's Mr. Wonderful to you. I have been all over this world. I have sold out buildings from the United States to Japan, and you name it. I beat Hulk Hogan, I beat Ric Flair, I've beaten everybody that's anybody in professional wrestling.
Mr. Wonderful, nobody has denied that. Nobody is saying that you aren't that kind of a competitor. But you just said you wrestle all around the world. You haven't wrestled enough here in Smoky Mountain to get the record to qualify without being a wild card.
You know something? Entrant. You're just about as smart as those rednecks out there. That's exactly what I'm trying to tell you. I have proven myself. I shouldn't have to come here and prove myself to these guys here who the best is. There's no doubt about it. I can beat any two of these guys at the same time. Both of them together don't weigh as much as me.
Wait a minute. Look, I'm Dixie Dynamite myself. Hey, we both grew up in the business. We both been professional wrestlers for so many years. And not only this, what is this, a violin? There is no violin into this.
Listen. Do you think for 1 minute that those people out there don't know that I can beat you?
Hold on.
Wait a minute, guys.
Hey, if you want to sell it, why don't you
sell it? I'll sell it any way I want to. I'm sick and tired of this garbage. Let me tell you something else, Bob Armstrong. You won't let me use my pile driver, but everybody else out here can use whatever they want to use. But no, you're afraid that I may hurt somebody. Well, you're dead dumb right I'm going to hurt somebody.
Talking is cheap. Let's do it in the ring. Talk is cheap. Let's do it in the ring.
Let's do it. Get it on. You can both of y'all go to the ring. How's that? You can even go with them and hold your hand.
Paul, I'm going to stay here. You guys go to the ring. Woo, what a wild time here. Let's do go up to the ring.
And hard to the turnbuckle. Guerrero now with those right hands just pounded right into the bridge of the nose.
Good lifter.
Forearm. Boy, that was a great one. There's another one. Set him down on his knees.
Spun him around on that one, but Orndorff hasn't beat Hulk Hogan for nothing. He hasn't beat Ric Flair for nothing. He's beaten the top names in this sport.
Eric Guerrero with a standing drop kick, and down goes Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff again. Guerrero there with that forearm uppercut of his own.
Let's see if Guerrero can continue his little rally here.
And Orndorff missed that elbow. He's got him covered. Only a count of two. Stacked him up for the count of two, but couldn't hold him for three. Here's Guerrero now.
He better be very careful with this one.
Flying crossbody off of the top rope.
He got him.
But Orndorff rolled right on through it. Held him there for the pin, but he held it tight.
Did you see it?
Yes, sirree.
The winner of the match, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
No, I didn't see it. Well, I didn't see it. I can truthfully say I didn't see any tight pull. See, Guerrero, he just mad because he lost. That stopped that undefeated streak here.
Well, and now Guerrero's still talking. There's Orndorff. He's after Guerrero now. Wait a minute, Dutch. He's going to put him up in a pile driver. That's outlawed. He's not supposed to be using the pile driver. Oh, no. Well, pile drive Guerrero right up in the ring.
Now, who's this in the ring? Ben Jordan.
He's going to pile drive him. There's Orndorff again with a pile driver.
That's two down. Who's this? Reno Riggins. Now, what's he doing?
He went right to the eyes of Riggins. He's going to set him up and pile drive. Hey, he's like a wild man in there with his pile drivers. That's uncalled for. No reason for this.
Man, he has laid three guys out right here. Three guys with the pile driver.
All with the pile driver.
Joey Maggs in.
Maggs has landed a couple of right hands.
He'll get the same medicine.
He goes to the corner, and Orndorff is not there now. He's going to set him up for it. Heck, he's going to have four of them laid out in the ring. Oh, with a pile driver. The pile driver's outlawed. Commissioner Bob Armstrong said he can't be using it. He's got four in the ring now laid out from that.
Well, now we see why Paul Orndorff wants to use the pile driver. Four guys laid out by one man.
And he's gone outside the ring. He's getting back in. He's got a chair in the ring right now.
Mr. Wonderful.
What the heck's he going to do with that?
He's going to be vicious today, it looks like.
You think he's really trying to send Commissioner Bob Armstrong and everybody with Smoky Mountain Wrestling the message that, hey, I should have been the number one seed in that tournament?
Well, they shouldn't have slotted him on.
He's going to pile drive him on the chair, on the metal chair. Dutch, there's no reason for anyone to be like a savage in there and do this.
I don't think he's sending a message. I think he's already sent it.
Here comes Dixie Dynamite.
Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff has shown a lot of contempt for wrestling fans here, but one man who stands for everything he doesn't is Morristown, Tennessee's White Lightning, Tim Horner. First, let's see Tim Horner in action, and then we'll hear from Tim Horner and Hector Guerrero.
Big deal.
Well, I'm not taking anything away from Horner. He's giving young Mr. Kazanis a wrestling lesson right now.
Well, he's wrestled all over the world, Dutch. He's returned to his roots here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and really for some really tough competition without all of the show business and some of the other groups, the big groups you know of professional wrestling.
Oh, I understand what you're talking about. See, Tim Horner really is an ultimate wrestler. He trains hard, he wrestles hard, he stays in shape, and when he goes out there, he goes out with the attitude to win. But see, two objects, a law of physics says two objects cannot occupy the same space at the same time. So one man has to win, one man has to lose.
Yeah, you see those big letters right across the back of the tights there.
Golden
Boy. I tell you, they really stand out, don't they? There's Horner now into the corner across the rope. And Kazana, with all of his weight and his pressure right down across that throat, trying to cut the air off of Horner. And if you do that, Dutch, it doesn't take a long time. You can be sucking air in a hurry if that happens to you, can't you?
Well, to other guys, to me, see, I swam underwater one time for 10 minutes. You know, I set a record. I'm in the Guinness Book of World's Record for holding my breath the longest underwater. Most guys, you cut the wind off, you beat them. But I'm just a little bit different. I hate to say that and bring it out on this program today, but it is true.
Yeah, you're a little bit different, Dutch. You're right. Well, there was Horner. He got that knee right to the back again as Kazana got high to the air with it. And Kazana now has got him to the air under the shoulder. Power slam as he just drives Horner to the mat and drives him to the mat hard.
Could be all over.
Through the ropes. What's he going to do here, Dutch? Looks like he's going out to get to the top rope. There's Horner. He was waiting on him. Watch out. It's a long way to the mat. Wow.
That looked like that hurt, Bob.
That hurt, and that had to hurt. Not only looked like it, but it had to. Hey, Dutch. Right here, let me just tell all of the fans, and something that I've been looking forward to, and I know you have too, we're going to see the debut of the Big Black Scorpion that's coming up in our next match.
The big black scorpion
black
right here on
scorpion.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Yes, sir. Horner, whipped to the ropes, comes right over Kazana. Held the rope that time.
Good
Kazana
move.
Face down
good
to the
move.
Mat. From behind.
Wait a minute, he's got him in his roll-up.
This he's is got the... him roll-up in a natural bridge right there.
Got him.
The roll-up in
the... And your winner is Wide Lightning, Tim Horner.
The roll-up in...
You know, Tim, just in a short while longer, I'm going to be ready to go. I've worn this for a while, and it's off now my neck, and I'm ready to go. You know, I know you got a score to settle with Paul Orndorff, you know. I just ask you one little thing. Save a little bit for me.
You know what this means, Hector? This means Lightning's going to strike, and that's what's going to happen May 22nd at the Volunteer Slam. Lightning is going to strike. Paul Orndorff, you come out here and you run your mouth, you down the people of East Tennessee and Smoky Mountain Wrestling Area. Well, I'm a part of those people. I don't like it one bit, and when the Volunteer Slam comes, I don't care who you beat. You may have beat Hulk Hogan. You may have beat Ric Flair, but you haven't beat White Lightning. And if by chance he gets me down a little bit and my little lightning bolt buddies start doing this, that means lightning's going to strike. And when it does, you're going down.
Well, it should be quite a confrontation when Paul Orndorff meets White Lightning Tim Horner. Wrestling fans will be right back after this.
And I'm going to go call Ticketmaster again, get this whole thing straightened out. My mother's not sitting in the back with all the rednecks.
Back to more Smoky Mountain wrestling action in the heart of West Virginia in just a moment. First, this reminder, wrestling in Beckley on Sunday afternoon. That's May 17th at 2 p.m. It's WOAY TV Channel 4 Day. Now, this is what that means. All kids under 12, only 4 cents. That's 4 cents with a paid adult. It'll be held at the Raleigh County Armory. That's in Beckley on Sunday, May 17th at 2 p.m. You'll see Dixie Dynamite against Dutch Mantell. Tim Horner will take on Buddy Landell. Robert Gibson against Jimmy Golden. Brian Lee against the Dirty White Boy with Ron Wright in the White Boy's corner. A special referee, Bob Armstrong, for that match. Six big matches in all, fans, including a Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team title match with Oak Hill's own Batten Twins against these guys, the Heavenly Bodies.
Let me ask you, did I hear you say all kids in for four cents in Beckley?
That's right.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's good. That's good. 4 cents. That's about what they're worth. Bring them on down there. It's cheaper than hiring somebody to sit home and watch them and slide them a fresh plate of dog food every now and then. Bring them on down there for 4 cents. And let them see what people from Oak Hill, what people from Beckley really look like. The Batten Twins. When they get slapped around by the Heavenly Bodies, the new Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. Just the same thing they did to the Fantastics. That's what's going to happen to Oak Hill's pride and joy, Bart and Brad Batten. Right, boys?
You know what? The only thing that makes me madder than coming to Beckley, West Virginia, is the fact that all those snotty-faced little punk kids under 12 will get in for just 4 cents. They ought to be paying $40 to see the Heavenly Bodies, right, Tom?
You see, the fact of the matter is, Stan, we didn't become the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions by being nice guys or hometown favorites. We did it by stepping in the ring, and we did it by beating people up. So, you see, if you want to bring a couple of guys like the Batten Twins who are from Beckley, West Virginia, it doesn't matter to us because you're looking at the greatest tag team champions that come to Smoky Mountain Wrestling yet, and we got the belts to prove it, boys. So, in Beckley, West Virginia, Batten Twins, lace them up good.
Well, wrestling fans, it's been quite a program, and it will be quite a night on Friday night here in Knoxville, Tennessee, for the Volunteer Slam. And don't forget, tickets for this big night of wrestling are on sale at the Knoxville Civic Coliseum and at all Ticketmaster locations. Your special ring announcers will be Will Hite and Wall from WIBK's Great Day program. And for the first 1,000 kids, Knox the Fox will give you a free picture. All kids under 12 admitted for only 43 cents. Quite a big match here.
Will Hite and Wall, these hot shots from WIVK Radio. It sounds like a roofing company or something, Will Hite and Wall. But I tell you something, it is going to be quite a night. This Friday night in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, the first round matches we've examined today are only the beginning. You're going to see two semifinal matches, then the finals, plus my Heavenly Bodies defending the Smoky Mountain Tag Team title against the Party Patrol, Johnny and Davey Rich, and we're going to thump them just like yesterday's garbage. It's going to be 9 matches all together, wrestling the way it used to be and wrestling the way I like it this Friday night in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. So
So if you're in Knoxville, you can't afford to miss it. If you're up there in West Virginia, if you're in Eastern Kentucky, over in North Carolina, wherever around the Smoky Mountain Wrestling area, get a plane, get a train, get a bus, a car, a boat, ride a horse, get a mule, I don't care. Hook up a sheep to a wagon, but somewhere or another, be in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum this Friday night. You can't afford to miss it.
Don't forget, wrestling fans, the Mountain Mayhem Battle Royal, $5,000 to the winner right here on TV next week. Until then, so long, everybody.